בעזרת השם, ליקוטי מוהר"ן, תורה מ"ב, 42. רבנו הקדוש is teaching us about the power of our soul. ואותיות התפילה היא השכינה. And the letters of the prayer, that's the שכינה הקדושה. כמו שכתוב, like that it's written, אדוני שפתי תפתח, שהדיבור הוא שם אדוני. The words Adonai Sefatai Tiftach of that verse are the Shechina Kedosha. When we say the word, the name of Hashem Yitbarach, the first word in that verse, Adonai Sefatai Tiftach, Ufi Yagid Tehilatecha, when we call Hashem like that, so actually we're aiming to the name of Hashem Yitbarach. So when is Hashem with us? When is Hashem with us? When Sfatai Tiftach. Adonai Sfatai Tiftach. Hashem will come to be with you when you're going to open your mouth and talk. Karov Hashem lechol korav. Hashem is close to everyone that calls him with truth. Shadibur hu shem Adonai. That the power of speech, the words themselves, they are the name of Hashem Yitbarach. How much we should believe in ourselves that our prayers are important. How much we should believe in ourselves that we are powerful by using the advice of Hashem Yitbarach. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is revealing His will to Am Yisrael from the world, from the people, that they will know by the stories of the Torah, of the Tanakh. He reveals His will in all of those stories in the history of Am Yisrael, what that we went through. Through those righteous people that led Am Yisrael, that took Am Yisrael to their success. From those stories, from whatever they went through, we're going to learn on the will of Hashem Yitbarach today. What really is going on today with us? When Am Yisrael, we're not counting on Hashem Yitbarach, just try to count on their kings, on their army, on their people, on other nations. So Hashem Yitbarach was angry. Hashem Yitbarach revealed His judgments. And then we lost our way. We lost our happiness. We lost our success. But when Am Yisrael are coming back and they're doing tshuva and they're praying to Hashem and they reveal their faith in Hashem Yitbarach again, so then kindness is surrounding us. So now, when we're saying that we believe in Hashem, we cannot say we believe in Hashem means we believe in what that's written in the Bible. We believe in the Bible. It's not a game here. I believe in the Bible. Yeah, I'm able to put my hand to make an oath that I believe in everything that's written in the Bible. It's not a game. We're talking about real life. We're talking about real life here. That if you believe that Hashem Yitbarach, He is the one that supplies Parnassah, you count on Hashem, on Parnassah. When you say that you believe that Hashem Yitbarach, He heals the sick people, that He is Rofe, Chol Basar, Umafli La'asot, that He is the one that makes wonders and can heal people. So if you just believe in the book and your faith is stuck between the pages over there, but when you're sick, you call the doctor, or you look for medicines to take something, or that immediately you think about tumors and cancer and dissecting your life to pieces, so you're far from faith in Hashem Yitbarach. If you would really believe in Hashem Yitbarach, you would go to Him when you would have problems, when you would have issues. You would run to Hashem, you would call Hashem. So when we're claiming to believe in Hashem Yitbarach, so we need to understand, okay, if now I believe that Hashem Yitbarach, He is the one that heals all of the sick people, so when I see a sick person, what I'm going to do? I'm going to pray. And Hashem going to heal. It means that Hashem going to heal. Think about the situation. Now there is a sick person in the second floor, and you want him to be healthy. Great. So now you pray for him 5 minutes, 10 minutes, until he's healthy, and then that's it. He's healthy. So now you made wonders. Now you are a righteous man. So that's your life story as a believer. As a believer, it will not just, no, I know that Hashem is healing everyone. Yeah, at 2 o'clock I have an appointment to my doctor. Second one this week already, and it's only Sunday. Okay, so first one was at 7:30. I took my wife, you know, she didn't feel so good. Oh, that's not life. That's a lie. That's a lie. That's not life of a believer. A believer is a person that believes in Hashem Yitbarach. And when we're talking about Hashem Yitbarach, we're talking about the one that makes wonders, that can bring your shiduch today. That can bring your shiduch today. That can buy you a house now. That can fix all of your issues today. Your mental issues, your health issues, your happiness issues, your depression issues, your anger issues, all of your problems. He can just fix it. Now, if you don't believe in Him, so what are you doing? That's what I'm asking all of the time. And that's my point of doing tshuva. Because when it hits me, when it came to me that really there is a creator, I was a soldier, I was in the army. I was busy, I had a jeep, I was clubbing, I was doing everything. I was very busy, my life was full with nonsense. I was very busy, very occupied. With all of my imaginations of being 20. I was smoking, I was drinking, I had some things to do in life. But when it came to me, hey, there is a private supervision here. Something is going on. Listen, it's not normal. It's not like it was before. Look at reality. Look at real life. Look at reality. Hashem is here. There is someone behind the curtains. There is someone behind the show. There is someone that is running the show. There is God. There is a creator. That's it. I stopped acting in that day. I stopped playing in that day. I went off the stage. I went behind the stage. I wanted to be from the managers. Okay, now where is the Bamai, the Tasritai, who is writing the script, you say? Mm-hmm. What's going on here? That's it. No more acts, no more fakes, no more lies, no more games. There is a creator to the creation. So now, if let's say yesterday, I'm thinking about one of our friends, and I'm thinking about that person. And suddenly, I have, in the middle of my itbodedut, I'm thinking about him, and I started to pray for him, and he is calling me. I didn't answer him, but I saw that Hashem is answering me. I'm praying on that person, I'm thinking about that person, and he's calling me in the same time. So, okay, I saw 100% private supervision, power of Hashem Yitbarach, that he's aware to my thoughts, that he's with me in my prayers, that guy is calling me immediately in the right time that I'm thinking about him. Okay, Hashem, what's your story to show me? What are you're praising yourself? You're proud. You're showing off your abilities now in my bodedut. Why are you doing that, Hashem? To show me that you're supervising. Okay, simple understanding. Great. So why you need to show me that you're supervising? That I'm going to count on you on the things that I'm not counting on you yet. To wake me up to see that Hashem Yitbarach is with me. Where? In the places I know that He's there. That I'm going to remember that Rabbi Nachman was holy. That I'm going to remember that the Tzion in Uman is important. That I'm going to know that Shabbat is a holy day. No, those things are clear for me. But that I'm going to remember that Hashem Yitbarach is supervising on every detail, in every moment, in every situation of my life, in the darkest situations, in the moments that I'm in stress, in the moments that I'm afraid, in the moments that I don't see things that are so clear and bright and obvious. In those moments, I need to remember. So Hashem is reminding me. So Hashem Yitbarach is bringing back the wisdom of his loyalty to his nation, to his people. And if we're not going to count on him, so we're also faking. If we're just going to try to do things and meanwhile to stay as we are, so we're faking. I promise you, you can live your life without sleep. You can live your life without eating. You can live your life even without the most important things in life like Limud HaTorah and Itbodedut. Trust me, you can live on air. you can live without air. You can live on Hashem Yitbarach. Rabbeinu once gave a class, and he said after the class, he said everyone were crying when he said the Torah. Everyone, all of the people were crying over there. In the end of the Torah, he said, I had an ability to pull you with that Torah for 3 days, days and nights. 3 days without eating, without drinking, and that you will not going to know if it's day or if it's night. I had that power. Because you have that power. Well, Rabbeinu's got that power. Rabbeinu going to use you. If now there is a sword, you don't know how to use that sword, but take someone, I don't know, a samurai, a ninja, a warrior, he's going to use that sword in an amazing way. Okay, now you're going to be amazed. It's not the sword. The sword have the ability. It's the warrior. Okay, now if Rabbeinu can use you and to keep you alive for 3 days, if Borei Olam can take Moshe Rabbeinu for 40 days, it means that it's planned inside, you've been programmed to that. Your body is able to live without food, without drink. You're able. In Moshe Rabbeinu, no. You think Moshe Rabbeinu was fasting? He was building himself like those crazy monks, Nazirim, that are torturing themselves and they're not eating and they're not drinking. You think that's the way of Hashem Yitbarach? Moshe Rabbeinu was building his skills, Shalom Aleichem. Moshe Rabbeinu was building his skills, developing himself, working on it, to fast for 40 days and 40 nights. Slowly, slowly, first of all, he dropped off meat, he stopped eating dairies, and then with the time, he was eating only tomatoes and cucumbers, and then he ate only crackers for another 3 months, and then he was also reducing the... No way! No way! Just in one day, Moshe Rabbeinu climbed to Har Sinai and he stopped eating and he stopped drinking. Why? Because he wasn't hungry. He wasn't thirsty. He was just with Hashem. So if you're going to be with Hashem, you don't need to eat. You don't need to drink. You don't need to sleep. I tell you, I promise you that. I don't know if you're not counting on me, so go look for someone else to count on. You have to follow someone. You have to follow someone because you cannot find the inspiration from inside. I followed Hashem Yitbarach, I followed my rabbi for day and night, for 12 years, I followed him with my eyes closed. Whatever he told me to do, I done. Whatever he told me to do, I was doing. I wasn't moving from a breath of a hair from what that he commanded me to do. When he was mentioning things, I was jumping on those things and I was committing myself to that. If he said to someone else, that it's a good thing, that you need to have a merit to pray for him, for Meira, for Avshalom. He said to someone else that it's a good thing for you to pray on him, to pray on Arav. I heard that. I said to myself, like I told you today, exactly the same. Why Arav is saying that when I'm here in the room? Why Arav is talking on that concept if I'm in the room? Why I need to hear it? Okay, Arav, you can tell that guy in a different time that he should pray for you. Why you done that now when I'm here? So for over 2 years, I was praying every day, half an hour on Arav. Every day I was praying for him, for more than half an hour. Every day on him. Why? Because I realized that Hashem is telling me something. And I wanted to commit myself to that. And when Arav was sick and they all went, there was a very big, generous person that offered everyone, I think it was $300 or I don't know how much, if they're going to do 6 hours on Rav Shalom, that he's going to be healthy. And it was amazing. It's great. And that guy came and they all came to the Kotel, all of the yeshiva. More than 100 people came and everyone made the 6 hours in Bodedut. And they gave to everyone. I don't remember how much dollars they gave everyone. When Nathan, his son, came to me and asked me, okay, Carl, take the money. I told him, you took the money? He told me, no. I told him, why? He said, because it's my father. I told him, and what's the difference between you and me? Why are you offering me money to pray on my father? He's my father also. You forgot it? I didn't. I made so many times 6 hours on him. Who can ask for money? I'm going to ask for money? What am I? A pimp? You're doing things for money? Are you a prostitute? Are you doing things for money? That's why you do things? You do things for money? That's what you do. You do things for money. Are you crazy? You serve Hashem Yitbarach for money. You go and do 6 hours for money. Are we sick? Who are we? We're serving Hashem Yitbarach for money.
We're doing things only because we know that Hashem Yitbarach, he's alive and exists. And that's why we're doing it. And if you see a righteous man, a holy man, a hero, someone that can lead Am Yisrael, so you nullify yourself to him. Throw your wisdom completely and you follow him in fire and in water. When he told me write the books, I was writing the books. When he told me do it b'deduyot, I was doing it b'deduyot. When he told me you should learn Torah, I was learning Torah. He told me you need to sit and learn with my son Shimon. I sat for I didn't know how to learn and I was sitting and teaching his son Shimon. And I didn't know how to learn. When he told me you need to be with your wife, I went home and I spent hours with my wife. When he told me you need to pray for your wife half an hour every day, I was praying half an hour every day. When he said in class that you don't need to pray on yourself and you need to pray on Am Yisrael, I dropped all of my tefillot. And from that day on, I'm praying only on Am Yisrael every day until today. In my itbodedut, I'm praying for Am Yisrael. All of the time I'm praying only for Am Yisrael. One of the friends asked me, what do you do when you need something for yourself? So I said, I'm mentioning it. In my itbodedut. I'm saying it once to Hashem. Hashem, I need to pay my mortgage. Hashem, I need to pay to the city hall. Hashem, I need to fix my car. Please help me. Moving on. That's it. That's the end of the novel with me. I'm mentioning it. Hashem, please, I need help. Please, Hashem, make my wife happy. If I see that she needs prayers, if I'm asking for myself, I'm going to mention it once. If I see that she needs help, I'm going to invest hours. I'm going to pray until I'm going to see results, until I'm going to see she's happy. I'm not going to drop that subject. Because I know that kol ha'marich b'tfilato en tefilato chozeret rekam. If you lengthen your prayers will not going to be empty-handed, will not come back empty-handed. You will be answered for sure, completely. You don't believe in that. That's why you're not praying. But if you believe that Hashem is standing in front of you, da'a lifnei mi ata omed, you should know in front who you're standing. Lifnei melech, malchei, amlachim, hakadosh baruch hu, king of all kings. He's standing in front of you. You can just take whatever you need. You don't believe in that. And when he's not answering you, so immediately you kofer. You say, no, he's not listening to my prayers. No, Hashem doesn't love me. You're talking lashon hara on the Creator. What are you doing? Immediately. When you jump to conclusions, immediately you cancel Hashem Yitbarach's kindness. Immediately, in one moment. No, Hashem is cruel. Hashem is evil. How can you even say those words? How can you think those words? If Hashem is not answering you, like I said before, if you see the private supervision of Hashem Yitbarach, if you see the greatness of Hashem Yitbarach in the world, in math, in medicine, in science, you see the greatness of the Creator, you see infinity, in that moment, drop your nonsense, your imaginations, your sadnesses, your angers, your lack of patience. Throw it. Just count on Hashem, because Hashem is life and exist. And I know, we spoke about that concept thousands of times until today. I know. But is there something else? What we're going to talk? The Super Bowl? The champion? Super Bowl? I don't know. Super Bowl. You want to talk about Super Bowl? What are we going to talk about? Hashem is live and exists, and we are not following him completely yet. And that's our tikkun. That's the only thing we need to come back to, complete faith. Now, can you tell me that if Hashem Yitbarach is sending you to the desert, you're able to go to the desert for 40 days? HaKadosh Baruch Hu is saying, I remember those days to you, that you were walking after me, in a bare land, in a land that wasn't planted, with no grass, with no food, with no bread. For 40 days, Am Yisrael were going in circles in the desert. Be'eretz lo zrua. Are you able to do that? Are you able to get into Eretz Yisrael? Do you have the power to go to Eretz Yisrael, to live in a place that looks like a desert? When they came to Eretz Yisrael, like a desert. They need to build it all from the beginning. All from Aleph Be'eretz, from the beginning. There was nothing here. Only wars, only desert, only thorns, only enemies, only wars, seven nations fighting against everyone, giants all around you, fighting with you. If you're not able to come today to live in Eretz Israel, really to live in Eretz Israel, land of faith, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is telling you, ארץ אשר עיני השם אלוקיך בא מראשית השנה ועד אחרית שנה. That's the land that Hashem Yitbarach is supervising on that land. Hashem is here. Hashem is here. Hashem is here. Hashem is with you. Stop whining. Stop complaining. Stop fighting with yourself. Go talk to Hashem. Tell Hashem Yitbarach, Hashem, build my faith. Let me believe in you. Let me count on you. That's it. Let's get over with my imaginations already. Let me stop counting on people. Let me stop counting on friends. Let me stop counting on rich people. Let me count on you. That I'm not going to be a beggar. That I'm not going to be pathetic. That I'm going to count only on you. That I'm going to throw all of my wisdoms. That I'm going to count only on you. That I'm not going to think that my wife can make me happy and that my children should make me happy and that my father should make me... No one exists, Hashem. Ein od milvado. There is no one except of you. And when you get that, so then, in that moment, like Rabbeinu said, when Rabbeinu lost his child, he had a little baby, that baby was supposed to be something like Mashiach. Probably was supposed to be Mashiach. It's not written, but it's hard to think something else except of that when you read what Rabbeinu was talking about that child. That child was supposed to be Mashiach, and he passed away. And Rabbeinu was beat, he was a wreck, he lost his everything he lost. He was crying, and there are stories that are telling that it's horrifying. You cannot even describe the sorrow and the crisis that Rabbeinu went through when he lost his child. And after that, he's saying, but you know, when Hashem is taking your child, so who took your child? Hashem. So actually, now you're even more close to Hashem Yitbarach, because your son is closer to Hashem, because in the world to come, you're closer to Hashem than in this world. So actually now I'm closer to Hashem Yitbarach. That's how Rabbeinu took things. It was very hard for him in the beginning, but when he was thinking about it, he said, who is torturing me? Who is rebuking me? Who is hitting me? Who is fighting with me? Hashem. So from that I see that Hashem haven't dropped me. Hashem haven't forgot me, that Hashem remembers me, that Hashem is taking care of me. And if Hashem is rebuking me and insulting me, so that Hashem yo'av, Hashem yochiach, Hashem is doing it out of his loving kindness. Because he sees that I'm not waking up by myself. What can I do? I know that about myself, that I'm not waking up alone. I need someone to wake me up. I need someone to shake me. I need someone to hold me in my ears and tell me, Hashem is here, Hashem is here, Hashem is here. So Hashem is doing it. So Hashem is sending people, and Hashem is sending friends, and Hashem is sending rabbis, and Hashem is sending books, and Hashem is making reality live for me, just ready to wake me up, to bring me closer to Him. And when He's doing that on one issue, I'm going to learn from that to that. If He's helping me in my Shalom Bayit, that I see Siyata Dishmaya, I'm going to know that from now on I can count on Him also on Parnassah, on money matters. And if he's helping me with money, with $500, I understand for me that I can learn, that I can buy a house in half of a million. Or in 2 million if I need. Because I know that Hashem, I saw Hashem. From the moment that you saw Hashem, if you're not going to believe in Him, in His endless powers, in His endless abilities, that He's able to achieve everything that He wants. He created the world. What's the problem for the one that made wind to pass air from one place to the other? For the one that made water to move water from one side of the world to the other? What's the problem? If Hashem Yitbarach gave you life, if Hashem Yitbarach is saying, Li ha-kesef ve-li ha-zahav ne'um Hashem, I own all money, all silver, all of the wealth belongs to Hashem, words of Hashem. So if that's the speech of Hashem Yitbarach, so what's the problem to deposit 300 million in Avram's bank account? What's the problem? No problem. For Hashem Yitbarach, it's easy. A lot of people inherit that amount. A lot of people suddenly receive that amount. What's the problem? For Hashem Yitbarach, it's not a problem. It can be a mistake in the numbers in the bank and suddenly Avram going to have that amount. It's not a problem. Hashem is doing those things. It's happened to a lot of people. Stupid enough to tell that to others, but it happened. It happened. What? Yes. You need to believe that Hashem Yitbarach is able to do everything. You can find wealth. You can find success. You can find health.
you can find happiness, you can find your shidduch, you can find your house, you can find everything you need, because it's in the hands of Hashem.
When you're standing in front of that situation, okay, why am I not married? I'm over 40, I have a good will, I want to commit myself to Hashem, I'm a Baal Teshuva, I'm doing good things in life, why am I not married?
So now, you need to understand, the one that is hiding your wife from you is the same one that can reveal her to you. Okay? So now, the same one that you're praying to him, that will find her, that's going to show her to you, is the same one that is hiding her from you for now. So if you're aiming, if you're calling his mercy, and you say, please Hashem, Berov Chasdecha, in your loving kindness, please reveal your mercy, reveal your love, give me the opportunity to get married, to find my wife, to find my shidduch, to have children. So, if that's who that you think that you're praying to, so also when he's hiding, you need to remember that it's the same one. There are no two authorities, two kingships. Only one Hashem Yitbarach, only one creator. So the one that is making the night, he is the one that makes the day. It's the same one. Hashem Yitbarach, he creates earth and heaven, night and day, good and bad. So if now you feel that something is bad, it's coming from the same source. So talk to that source. And go into the truth, into the fog, into the arafel. Kishama Elokim, because God is over there. When Hashem Yitbarach went on Mount Sinai, there was clouds, there was a fog, there was thunders, there was fire, there was fireworks, there was a lot of noise over there. You think that Moshe Rabbeinu saw everything clear? No. Moshe Rabbeinu went into the darkness, into the fears itself, into the frightenings, into the thunders, into the rain, into the fire. Why? Because he knows no one can hurt me, no one can harm me. If now you know that there is someone in danger, you have time to think, am I the person to save him or not? He's dead already. If you just let the time pass, he's dead already. Only if you're gonna run between the bombs, between the fire, between the bullets, and then you're gonna, Hashem gonna help you. And if you died, so you died. Do you care so much? Why do you care so much? If you died in a war to save your land, to save your nation, to save your soldiers, your friends, your brothers, your sister, and you died. Let's say you died. You rather to live all of your life as a coward that remembers that he let his brothers die in the field, in the war zone, and that's it, and to live your life with that memory, maybe I could save my brother and I didn't. You want to live like that? I would kill myself if I had that thought. I would kill myself if I had that thought. Who wants to live like that? With the feeling I could have saved my brother and I let him drown? How can you live? And if you are in a situation like that today, that you say, I could do something, I was, I had that opportunity and I missed it. No, if you're still alive, it means you can still fix. So now start saving brothers. Now start saving sisters. Now go and talk to people. Now go and help people. I also made a lot of damage when I was secular, when I was 20, before, when I was 16, I caused a lot of damage. But I decided that I want to fix. Rav Shalom once told us that he heard, I don't know, from a hidden tzaddik, from Rav Levovich, I don't know what, that he is a Gilgul, he came in a different lifetime, of, I think it was Achav. Achav was the king of Am Yisrael that destroyed the world, that killed more than a million people in his life. And Rav Shalom said that everything that he's doing today in this world, all of the distribution of Atzah, saving lives, helping people, it's all to fix the sin of being Achav, the king of Israel. So I came to him one time, I'm rude, what can I do? I came to him and told him, Arav, really? If you're going to find yourself standing in Judgment Day after 120, in front of Hashem, and he's going to tell you, you fixed it all. You're standing at zero. Everything that you done, paid your debt. You paid your debt. Great. You're standing now after 120 years with zero. You killed a million people. You saved 1 million people's life. Great. Now you're standing in zero. What are you going to do then? He told me, I'm going to be very happy. I told him, really? He said, yes. If I'm going to know that I fixed what that I ruined, I'm going to be very happy. Think about any other different answer. Would be very, very bad, very bad answer. If you're able to owe someone something and you don't care about that, you don't want to pay, like I explained to you about hell. Hell, it's a punishment. People are afraid of hell. What are you afraid? If they're going to send you to hell, it means you need to pay for something you've done. You don't want to pay on what that you've done, so who are you? You're a criminal. You stolen from me 100 shekels and now you don't want to pay. They tell you you need to go for 1 minute to hell to pay for my 100 shekels that you stolen them from me. You say, no, I don't want hell. So you don't want to pay back, but you owe me that money. So who are you if you don't want to pay? Any surim belavon, if you're suffering on your crimes. So if you suffer now in this world, you need to be happy. At least someone is taking care of you to help you to fix. So if you're suffering, so it means that Hashem is helping you to fix what that you need to fix. So be happy. Be happy with what that Hashem is doing to you. If Hashem Yitbarach, he deciding to show his mercy on us in a way that it's still hard for us to understand and to accept, it doesn't change the fact that he is doing it out of his kindness. Sometimes you cannot grab it. Sometimes you cannot understand it. Sometimes it's hard for you to think. Okay, don't think. But at least don't think bad thoughts about Hashem, because you don't understand him. You don't understand him, so go talk to him about it. Take that wisdom and go talk to Hashem about it. Go take that experience and go talk to Hashem about it. Go tell Hashem Yitbarach, I cannot understand you. I don't understand what you're doing with me. I feel like you're causing bad things in the world, Hashem. I don't understand you. Please explain yourself to me. Chanoch lanar al pi darko. You need to educate me according to my vessels, to my abilities, to my way. Because in another way, I won't understand you ever. So please, Hashem, explain to me. And then by doing that, by talking words of truth in the Itbodedut, in the Tefillah, you open a lot of new sources of light in your life and new opportunities for yourself to purchase knowledge, to buy understandings, to buy wisdom, to get some understanding on how Hashem Yitbarach is running your life, how Hashem Yitbarach is leading the world. And when you're going to ask questions of truth that are coming from an honest place and you will want to know the truth, not to be saved, not to be redeemed immediately. First of all, to have a desire for the truth, to ask for the truth, to seek for the truth. When you're going to find the truth, you're going to actually bring a lot more truth to the world, not only for yourself. Because when the light is going to shine on you, it's going to shine on your environment. It's going to shine on your family. It's going to shine on your company. It's going to shine on your people, on your friends, on everyone that is close to you. Baruch Hashem, there's a lot to talk, Baruch Hashem, and thank God that Hashem is helping us every day to clarify another point and another point. And thank God, Tzadik Atamar Yifrach, that it takes so many years for the palm tree to grow and to bring out some such sweet fruits. So a righteous man, that he's going to achieve that level of bringing good, sweet fruits, it takes him years and years to achieve that. So it's good that we're still not fixed. It's a segula for long life. Hashem going to give us all long life. We're going to grow. We're going to develop. Every day we're going to water ourselves a little bit more with water of faith, water of Torah, water of tefillah, water of mitzvot. And Bezrat Hashem. Slowly, slowly, we're going to reach our purpose, complete faith in Hashem Yitbarach, to know Him, to recognize Him, to follow Him with a wishing soul, with a happy heart. Thank you very much. Chazak Baruch.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Obi from the Emunah Channel here in Jerusalem. subscribe to the channel. It means a lot to us. It means a lot to Rav Dror. So show me some love. Show Rav Dror some love. Subscribe to the channel. We post new videos almost every single day. Awesome classes like this. If you have any questions on the classes you just watched or just other questions that you have or comments that you want to tell us, post them in the comments below. And we do a question answer session every single week. So we'll either answer your question in that on video or we'll make sure to get you an answer. And of course, check out emunachannel.com. Awesome website where we have tons more inspirational content. We have videos, blogs, music, and all sorts of cool stuff. So get involved over there at emunachannel.com, and we'll see you in the comments.